Hey everyone, Shawn and Sav at your service. This week we're talking about rhythm, timing, tempo, all of the stuff that you need to perform greatly in this game. And you know, this is really going to help you with your consistency. So you'll need a section of a gym rope. I cut a section off about the length of a driver. If you have a lag shot, that's really going to help you out. You'll really understand how this all works. And the visuals are just going to be amazing for you. So please settle in, enjoy the show. Can't wait for you to see this. So I'm going to start with the rope, right? So if we swing this piece of rope in both directions, you'll notice that at one point the rope taps me on the shoulder, right? It gives me a little tap on the arm. And then after it taps me, it starts coming back the other way. That's the window of opportunity for delivering the swing. So if you wait too long and it stalls out, now you have to jerk it into motion. And if you don't wait long enough, it's going to slap you across the back. Also, you'll notice that when you do that back and through without stopping, if your backswing is too low, you can't, there's no way back. So the rope has to go in a very specific height to be able to come back and through properly. So there's a bonus there for you as far as swing plane and understanding that swing plane and how everything tracks from that particular height. If you're too high, it drops. And if it's too low, it drops. So as I swing back and through and I'm waiting for that tap, you'll notice now when you do it with the regular swing, that little tap, and you'll see this in so many players. You see this in Ernie Els's swing. Those who tend to swing more slowly, as they get to the top of the swing, that little set in the wrists, see that little bounce? Boing. So as it settles, that's my cue to get that going in the opposite direction. You're going to see Sav now do it with the lag shot. And because the lag shot is so flexible, the flex in the shaft gives it that little bounce. And that's what makes that tool so effective to swing. So Sav, come and show them. So swing back and through without stopping. And all of you will see the transition is so smooth. There's no way that you could rush that, Sav, right?
No.
I mean, the damn thing will be flying all over the place.
Yeah.
So we got a nice little par 3, 150 yards, and we're just going to casually wait for the tool. Bad. So would you say you waited for that one adequately?
Could have waited a little more.
Could have. You felt it, right?
Yeah.
And that's the cool part, is it really tells you what's going on. Wow. You felt it there, didn't you?
Yeah.
What a difference. And there it is. So with the rope, you can't mess that up.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, with the lag shot, it really opens up your awareness as to when the appropriate time is to deliver.
Yeah.
And it's not like you can deliver with a lot of effort, can you?
No.
Thank you. Because if you jump on that thing, it's just going to overbend and overload.
Yeah.
And it's very hard to time when it does that.
Yeah.
So when you pay attention to it. Very nice. Very cool. All right. So now I've got a lovely little 172 par 3. I'm going to use my 7-iron, little fade. Obviously, you can see the tree is preventing me from hitting draw here. So I'm waiting for the weight of the club, and I'm not interrupting the flow. I'm staying out of that manipulative interference. So I feel the weight of the instrument, and I let it go. So there comes a time where you'll feel like if you wait too long, it's going to stall out for you. I was on the verge on that one there. And then so watch now how I use a little bit more momentum to deliver that. See the diff? So that one stayed on track. That should be all over it. And so notice there was a little bit faster pace on that. If I get to the top and then it starts to stall out and then it feels like I have to jerk it into motion, that's what it felt like on the previous one. So let me see if I can finish with a nice one here for you. Feel the weight of the instrument. And I'm just waiting for... There it is. So one of the videos that you'll really appreciate is the Fred Astaire golf dance. And it's been, you know, it's done its rounds on the internet, but it's always beautiful to watch. And you'll really see how predicated it is on rhythm and timing to execute the shots. And that's what keeps Fred Astaire in the game. He was a single-digit handicap at Bel Air Country Club in Los Angeles. Isn't that cool? I got my own cue. Wow. How about that?
Very nice. Great timing.
Spot on timing.
Smooth.
Right?
Perfect.
So that was my soft 7-iron,
mm-hmm.
right? So now if we put a little bit more...
A bit more of an oomph in it?
A bit more of an oomph, you'll okay. notice that, and that's what I keep telling my students. I said, the oomph doesn't happen in the backswing. It doesn't happen in the transition.
It happens...
It only happens through the strike.
Yeah.
All right, so now firm 7-iron. Nutted every one of those. Right? So enjoy that. We'll see you next time.